guys, it's Ivy here. Welcome back to another Let's Play episode of our Silverton Zoo. In last episode, what we got to do was we added some more foliage all around, so everything is looking way more lush and complete, filling in all of these gaps. Again, I get some of you guys may not have watched it just because it can be kind of redundant. So here is everything that like we've done that episode. Looking around, added some ivy, and then we changed the top here to be like a lattice with the ivy on it and going down. And then we've got all this, added some more plants down here. I still need to work down here, but I'm not sure exactly what yet we're gonna do, if we're going to end this little area over here or if we're gonna continue on maybe this way on some habitats. I'm not sure exactly yet. But, so, oh, and something else I did off camera. I went in here and I added a sign. This is that sign. I've never used it before. It's the New World Editable Arch. I didn't even know that existed, honestly. I just happened to peek at it and I was like, oh my gosh, that's perfect. So like when you look for it, it's red, but you can obviously change the colors on it. So I thought that looked really good. And so this can be like our reptile side, which would explain more why this is closed off and, you know, more like not as open as over here, like what we have with the platypus habitat, how this is more open and not like walls. It's more of like the terrarium type of feel. And another area I just wanted to show you guys is over here. We've got our little waterfall coming down. Excuse me. And I ended the waterfall right here. I thought about adding a grate here to make it look like, you know, the water comes down and then it immediately goes into the grate. But I think the rocks here do a good job of acting like there's a grate hidden in there. You know, the rocks just kind of block it and where you can't see it. So that's why I did that. We'll just check out our bat cave here. I'm telling you, this one never moves. Just looking at them. I don't ever like come over here and look at them often, so I don't even know if they really do move or if they have like the same like flight pattern, if that makes sense, like where some of them have the same animations where they'll fly and like land there. Oh, okay, our Komodo dragons. I'm gonna pause this real quick, get out here, hopefully. Come on, I don't know why it does that. I guess if I'm too close to the ground, it won't let me change the camera view. So anyway, we've got our Komodo dragons, finally, the rest of them aged up. So these are all the babies. We are going to go ahead and just release those guys into the wild. Oh, and I don't know if you guys remember, I was having a ton of problems with our Nyala habitat, with it not being clean. So I dwindled down the population as much as I could, thinking that maybe they just, it was too populated, there was too much, you know, poop in the habitat. But actually what happened was, I guess, here, we'll go over this way and show you. You can still kind of see. I guess what happened is one of these guys died in the water, and I had no idea. I didn't even see. I don't know why I didn't think it wasn't possible for them to die in the water, but it was. So their body was over here, and you can still see like a bone in here where the keeper didn't suck this one up for some reason. But yeah, there were bones in this water, and I guess from where one of them died, and that's why these guys were so unhappy and why their habitat was not clean. I completely understand that now, because when there is a dead animal, and especially for that long, it definitely makes it almost impossible to keep the habitat clean per se. So that definitely makes sense there. And let's see, let's do a little bit of management here. I do want to add an animal in this round. I'm not exactly sure which one yet. I have it dwindled down to two different animals right now. But again, I'm not sure exactly which one I'm wanting to do. It's in the trade center, and this one is not. So we will just release you. Alright, and that's still playing through. We've got all these guys still. We've got our anteaters from, I believe it was last episode that we got her a boyfriend. So she's pregnant. She should be having baby soon. Oh, we have baby platypus. Pusses? Is that even the right word? Oh my gosh. Platypi. I think it's platypi, isn't it? Baby platypi? Kind of like octopus. You say octopi. Oh my goodness. Oh, look how cute. Just rolled up in a little ball. I'm telling, they don't look like they should be real. They just don't look like a real animal. That one just taken off. They are so precious. Oh my gosh. I didn't even know that they were born. Oh, and their gold stat is, were their parents gold? I can't remember. I try and get gold if I can. Okay, the one is, and then the one baby is gold. So that makes sense. I got it. We've got a couple baby hippos in here. I need to pause this because I hate like having to do that, but I can't search through all these animals. Baby Beatrice. Okay, we only have 56 animals now, which is good. Really, I could get rid of some of these bats. I don't think that would hurt anything. Especially the ones that aren't like any special status. Get rid of you. You're not gold status. Get rid of you. And then we'll quick trade them. $6,000 for them. That's crazy. It's weird to me that you can't trade the exhibit animals. You would think that you would be able to, but you can't. I guess I should be making sure that all of our exhibit animals are still in there. So there's the one. I'm thinking we lost our two iguanas, so we probably have empty exhibits over here for the where the iguanas were. Yeah, see, empty. And empty. Okay, so we need a green iguana and a lesser iguana. So let's find the green iguana. I want one that's young. Okay, you're young enough. Green iguana and the lesser iguana. Okay, I want the young one. All right, send you here and then go back in, I think, right? Yeah, and then go back in here and send you here. And then, okay, yeah, because I don't have, it's still throwing me off where they said that we bred exhibit animals because I know that we didn't. We just have one of each to keep them from breeding. So I'm not sure where that even came from. Okay, he's only 15 years old, so that's still good. Let's go ahead and start playing through again. And our zoo is pretty well off. Yes, education, I swear, it's impossible. It's not, you can't. I've done everything like in my power that I am aware of to get them to where it needs to be, and it never works. So, I mean, if you guys have any suggestions on that kind of stuff, let me know. Sorry, I'm trying to get this color right. I was noticing earlier, I was kind of going through here and doing some things off camera. I was like, I didn't add any rocks to their habitat. So let me keep this from aligning to surface. Maybe. Okay, change the color back. Just put some rocks down over here. Oop, if we can stay in the terrain, or the terrarium. Ah! Oh my god. No, it went down. Okay, there we go. Wow, I hate when that happens. Okay, so we want you like right there, and then this like right over here, and we will add some rocks over here because they're not able to go up in here anyway, so that works. See if we can add a couple more over here, maybe add a couple more in the water just for aesthetic purposes. All right, so we got that going. And I guess since the last couple episodes have been a lot of management, I guess we'll go ahead and cut this one kind of short management-wise, and we'll go ahead and start working on a habitat. I think I'm going to go ahead and do the short-clawed otter. I believe that's what it is, or did I butcher that? Asian small-clawed otter. We're going to try and put them over here, kind of back to back with the platypus, and then, you know, they can enter, kind of have like the same feel of the habitat right over here. And then we'll obviously have like two other habitat animals, which I know which ones I'm going to do there, but you guys will find out as the episodes go through. But yeah, so I will go ahead, I'll wait until it stops raining, and we'll go ahead and hop into the speed build. All right, guys, and we are back. I just thought it was a good time to hop back in here. I know I need to go in here and add a couple more toys for these guys. They need a couple more. See if that does anything, and that didn't do anything. Toy enrichment. What? That is ridiculous. Does the platform? No, platform does not count for anything. Maybe the submarine toy? And I really thought that, like, that would go down on its own, but I guess not. So there's that. And maybe, like, the small bubbles. Oh, somewhere, maybe. Guess we're running out of space. Oh, obstructed. I really think it's like the mud bath that they want, but obviously we don't have enough room to put the mud bath. Yeah, if I put that there, it's gonna be inaccessible, so that makes no sense to do that. Let's do small ice ball. We'll just stack it back there as it rolls down the hill. And we will do, oh, and into the water, as everything else is. And I can't, like, stuff this back in here anywhere. I don't know, guys. Alright, that's at, like, 52. I think that's good enough. It's just crazy, like, they need that much. But anyway, so here is our little habitat. I was starting to make a shelter for this, and then I remembered that I actually don't have to make the shelters because this whole thing counts as their shelter. So that's the perks of building in the terrarium, is that you know, you don't have to build them shelters, which works because we are working with very little space. That is fine. I do think I want to, like, try and put this one over here somewhere. And I want to block the guest view of, like, underwater, but I want them to get that look of them being able to, like... Alright, maybe that'll be okay. I still think they can see just fine. The kids might be having a little trouble, but everybody else can see. And another thing I'm not sure about is if they will... Okay, it says that it's accessible, but, yeah, so I tried to hide this away the best I could, and I thought these little stair pieces would work fine. I don't know yet if I like that, though, or not. They're kind of, a little off-putting. Let's see if there's something else that we can put there instead. Maybe it's just the color of them. Maybe if I change their color, it would look a little bit better. Change it to, like, a dirt color or, like, the rock color. Maybe we'll do that and then just try and find, like, a couple more little rocks to put around there. Not that. This, like, put, okay, there's another one. I know there is. Is it this guy? Really as small as I wanted him to be. That, like, right there, and then move you, like, up and over, and just kind of, you know, make them not look the same. Yeah, that's all right, I guess. I wish I could put it, like, I wonder if I get rid of this, and maybe even, like, these rocks, if I could put it up here, because that would be ideal. My goodness, of course not. So yeah, like right here is the only place I can put it. Oh, I can just hide it away in the grass. It wasn't letting me do that before. Okay, problem solved, and then we can get rid of this eyesore. There we go, guys. Get rid of you. And then let me duplicate you and put you back over here. Okay, and then they've got like little bedding areas to sleep in. And I don't know if this will like technically, yeah, there's no way this thing is fitting in here. Okay, we gotta pause real quick because we have some stuff going on over here. Pygmy hippos are out of control. That's okay, thank you for the research. And animals, pygmy hippo, you need to go too. Okay. You're our dude. You need to go. All right, and the rest is good. So we'll just release these guys into the wild. The pygmy hippos are crazy pricey. I didn't even know that like they were worth that much, but hey, I'll take it. That should be good. And our little guys are more than happy. I guess we're having some issues with the navigational land underneath, which sounds about right, per usual. Probably has something to do with, like, these rocks. Maybe I can just, like, move them down a little bit, and that would help. Let's see. Did that do anything? I don't think it did. I don't know. I think, like, these plants play a huge part in, like, them being able to dive and stuff. Which makes no sense. I don't feel like it should matter. Okay, we did get it back up a little bit. Okay. Then maybe, like, move this one down a little bit, too. And maybe that'll do something else. Maybe? Possibly? I don't think that did anything. Maybe move the plants down a little bit. Where you can, like, kind of see them, not really see them. These guys. That. Alright. We're going to be stop and go. Stop and go. Anything? No. Which, again, makes, like, no sense. Okay, I don't know why you're just floating up there. So we'll get rid of you. See, like I said, like, it's hard to believe that this would really cause that much of an issue. Maybe we can just put this guy, like, over here. You might be part of the issue. So move you like that. Maybe like up a little. See you now. It's definitely after I put the plants in is when the stuff like starts to go downhill. And the rocks, obviously the rocks, but I don't know. I just don't. You gotta have rocks down here. The more I'm playing this game, the more I'm learning rocks in the underwater areas is really, like, what makes the underwater areas. Like, you can't just really not have them. Put you down a little bit. Some of these guys, as long as they're just peeking through, I'd imagine would be a-okay. All right, I'm trying to click on you. There we go. And do that, maybe. Like that a little bit. Can you peek through a little bit more down at the bottom without being obnoxious? Okay, maybe. And then this guy's doing something too. All right. Sorry, I wasn't expecting to, like, you know, still be touching up their habitat, but here we are. Put this guy down a little bit. Okay, yeah, that's good. And you down a little bit, maybe, and maybe you. And let's try and get you down some, too. I think these, I just found these when I was doing this habitat, actually. And they make a really good, like, pop of color for in the underneath area. All right, it's not getting any better. I think the only way it'll get better is if I delete some of the rocks, and I'm just not going to. And I still don't understand this at all, that it makes no sense. Navigational deep water area, but navigational, I just don't understand why they're different. Like, swimming should be, I feel like one should just be, like, water area that they need in their habitat, and the other should be swimming, and there shouldn't be, like, a depth, if that makes sense. Because I've seen this, like, where animals require this, but they don't have to swim in it. They just need a little bit of water in their habitat. So, I like I said, I don't understand it. Maybe someone can explain it to me. I would greatly appreciate being explained what I'm doing wrong here. Because even these guys are struggling. And, like, I had their habitat, like, super pretty underneath. And it is just... like, this is just a mess now. What are you talking about? Overcrowding? We really have too many. Okay, well, let's get rid of you. Oh, no, we can't because you're... that doesn't make any sense. Really? Overcrowding? How many do they like in their group? I don't even remember. Okay, pygmy. Per usual, we're all over the place. Come on, let's spell pygmy right. Pygmy. Okay, 2 to 4. So they definitely have too many. Okay, get rid of you. Let's get rid of you because you're going to be the dad to them. And we'll get rid... I wish I could get rid of you, but you're pregnant. So we'll just hang on to those, maybe. Okay, we'll just do this real quick. We'll just do that and then... see how it works. But yeah, so I'm gonna have to put a sign up over here now. It says mammals for our little mammal area. These guys are looking good. You know, I might do a little like make it this episode extra long and just try and fix up this area, because I can't look at this anymore. Like that. I can't. Okay, let's see. Like I said, it makes no sense. That makes no sense. I just don't get it. Okay, let's pause again and let's go into fixing their water area, because I'm tired of looking at it like this. I should have never left it like this. So let's fix this up. Alright guys, so we're back. We've got this underwater area looking way better than what it was. I need to try and click this water, if it will even let me, which I've figured out once you have a bunch of like rocks and stuff in here, it's darn near impossible to actually click the water itself. So we're just gonna click around for a minute, see if we can actually get the water. And that probably will not happen, go figure. Let's go down. I would like the water, please. Water, please. Water, please. Okay. No, I knew that there had to be a way to do that. I just didn't know how, so I just figured that out. Here we go. All right, so they're good, and I have figured out that the reason why they are probably struggling so much with their water and everything is because their babies grew up. So we need to look at the platypus and get rid of their babies. Yes, get rid of you and you. We will just release them into the wild, and then they should be far better off with everything. Oh, maybe if I can click on you, per usual. Okay, yes, that's way better off. Still not perfect, but way better than what it was. So, they are good. And then we, oh, she's expecting offspring again. Well, release three pygmy hippos. We've got that going, and then we've got these guys happy as can be over here. I wonder if, because I don't know, it's just looking like a little bear right there. Let's not align to surface. Let's like see if I can put you like right there, and maybe like something right there. I don't want to keep putting down the same thing, so I don't think you will. Maybe put some more. Okay, that might work better. And I'm not sure. See, everyone else can put this grass down and it looks great. It looks amazing. It looks so realistic. But every time I put it down, I feel like it just looks like a clump of bleh. Like, it doesn't look good. It doesn't look real. It does not look good at all. I don't know. You guys let me know in the comments if you guys think this looks okay, if we just need to, like, scrap that and just leave it be, like, put something else there maybe. I don't know. Let's see how these guys are doing. I want to just humor me and see if that even does anything for them. Oh my gosh, no way! That alone was hindering that much? Wow, okay. Well, I liked how it looked under there, but not if it gives it like over 100 more. Wow, that is crazy. Okay, well, lesson learned. I hate this roof already being back. I just did that so like the otters would be okay and not be upset they didn't have any area to be in. So we'll see how long that lasts. I'm just gonna pause this for a second, see what's going on, check on our vet research. Okay, so we've got that done. We are just trying to knock all of these out as quickly as we can, though. So we've got three going, and like, you know, every now and then I put an animal in, so I'm trying to get our research back up with, you know, our animals that we put in, because right now we're really far behind on it, and I don't want that. Is this water clear? Crystal. Transparency. Ooh. Watercolor? Ooh. I'm sorry, I've not, like, messed with this that much. Well, that kind of looks like a nice swampy color. Bubbles and mist. Okay, sorry, I was, like, looking into that way too much. So let me, I'm probably doing a lot, and you guys are probably over it, but but I just want to go ahead and move this over here. Obviously not reptiles. So we are gonna go in here and do mammals. Mammalus. Hopefully that's right. It's like, I know how to spell this stuff, but the minute I'm on the camera, I'm like, did I spell that right? Like, I promise, I'm not like, mammals. Okay, yeah, that's it. Okay. It's just like, you know, like, you look at it and you're like, man, that kind of looks wrong. I think it's because of the arch in it. And I'm like, eh. All right, water treatment center two. Why are guests back here? What are you guys doing? What? You guys are crazy. Get out of here. Skedaddle. Oh my gosh. If it's not one thing, it's another, I swear. Get out of here. Play this through. Now y'all turn around. Go back. Go home. Y'all are terrible. Move. Now get. Get on now. Get. Get on down the road. You go away. You're not supposed to be here. Get out of here. Oh my gosh, this is infuriating. Like, what makes you think you should be back here? And I did not mean to click on that. Okay, so we're good on the plot. Okay, go get. I'm trying to get these. Get. Get on now. Maybe if I can click on you guys. Come on. Go. And you guys all go. And you guys go too. And you, lady, by yourself, go. I always question these people that are here by themselves. Like, I don't know. I'm just weird. I guess I always have to go with somebody. And if I'm not with somebody, I, like, feel awkward. But I guess we should start normalizing that. Just going places by yourself. My gosh. I just want to click on these guys. And I can't. Here we go. Move you guys. Now get on now. I think that's everybody. Thank goodness. Telling me that they're mad about the... Like, well, you're not even supposed to be back there. More vet research. Whoop, whoop. Getting her done, guys. Getting her done. All right. Put you on there. One, two... Three, only three more left, guys. Well, four technically. But three more after the ones we're researching. Wait. I totally made no sense. Hang on, we gotta look now. One, two, three, four, five, six. We have six left, but we're researching three. This one's about done. So in all technicality, we have five. Okay, I completely butchered that. I'm sorry. It made sense in my head, and then when I, like, spit the words out, I'm like, no, that doesn't make sense. I need to do something with this. This is so bleh. This is really bleh. Okay, we'll save that for another episode. I need to, like, do more stuff in here, because these are looking bleh and, like, very, like, cookie cutter. So, but this episode has definitely gone on long enough. I know that, so if you guys stuck through this episode, I greatly appreciate it, and I hope you guys are enjoying our series, and our zoo is looking way more lush and way better, and I am just so excited. We are getting this thing done, and I'm just so pumped. But anyway, guys, we will hop in here real quick and take a look at our otters. But yes, guys, thank you so much for tuning into my channel. I remember to like and subscribe if you haven't already. I greatly appreciate it. And thank you guys so much for watching. And I hope to see you all in the next one. Bye, guys.